Oh, hey.
Welcome, friends.
We're out here in Cashe Creek, British Columbia. The whipper winds are flowing. This is an awesome town. I think the only thing in this town is hotels. I mean, like within this section right here, there's motel right there, hotel right here, hotel right here, another one right over there. I can't remember the name of this one. This one was called the Sundowner. And we decided to go with the Sundowner because of the name. So tonight we're gonna stay here, and then tomorrow we'll be on our way up to Smithers, BC. I'm glad you came. Join us.
Like, who are you talking to?
I'm talking to my friends right here. And I'm gonna show them the Sundowner in Cashe Creek. Now, what does $70 get you in Cashe Creek? Isn't that what we paid for this? $74 in Cashe Creek, British Columbia. We have the full-size bed. The mattress is indented in the middle, which is perfect. It means it's been used properly. One light here, another light here. There's a TV. There is Wi-Fi too. That's pretty cool because the phones don't really work up here very well. The thing I really want to show you, though, is this toilet. You're going to like this. It's sloping sideways. I don't understand how it's working. I tested it. It's stable, but I think it's the whole building is sloping down.
Well, the whole toilet is, so you can see it's lifting.
It's sloping, but she's solid. So I'm going to go ahead and take a poop on it. What do you think?
Go ahead, just lock the door, close the door.
And they actually did give us a couple towels and some shampoo and whatnot. So are you tired now?
Yeah, now I'm like, I'm ready.
All right. What a fine establishment, the Sundowner Hotel. I'd highly recommend it. They say $84 a night, but we hooked it up on booking for $74, $10 off. And now the sun is coming up, the moon's going down, it just went down over the horizon there. And we are gonna head north. First 100 mile house, Williams Lake, finally Prince George, and then on our way to Smithers and Terrace, BC. Ooh, there's a DQ over there. All right, let's go get some coffee.
Washington here.
Next up, Williams Lake. It's pretty dry out here.
Yeah, Tim Hortons. Can't forget Tim Hortons.
Use the right lane to keep right.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
This way?
Right lane to keep right.
Oh, check out the moon over there.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
That's a picture worthy.
That is. That's a good omen.
Full moon. Look at the fire that went.
Oh yeah.
I just read about
major fires. We're gonna go by even further up north. We'll see some major, huge fires that they had years ago. We've arrived at 100 mile. Actually, it looks like it's still only 99 mile by the looks of all the signs around.
Supermarket.
Check out the vastness of British Columbia. All right, where's Tim Hortons? Tim Hortons, Tim Hortons, Tim Hortons. That's my Tim Hortons song.
But I see gas station for your windshield.
Okay. What is this? Is that a moose? Is that, oh no, it's a person, whoa. It's a person on a bike.
Something was quite clear. Look at those giant skis.
It's kind of a mecca of cross-country skiing around here.
They have sushi and noodles. Pub and grill. It's all closed.
And once again, this is like, there's probably like 20 hotels here.
Yeah, we passed by Ramada and Super 8.
There's the Imperial. We need to come back here and just stay at all the hotels. Okay, let's.
Oh, Tim Hortons, this is it.
Okay, let's go to the gas station first and get some juice for the windshield wipers.
Yeah, it'd be nice. Is it
open? Tim Hortons, Tim Hortons, Tim Hortons.
Petrol.
We have arrived in 100 Mile House, town, something like
that. Dollar Tree, your cash solution. Remember those guys? Commercial.
They even have 7-Eleven in Canada.
Tim Horton grew up, played hockey on frozen ponds in Ontario. By the age of 19, he was drafted to the NHL by the Toronto Maple Leafs. With them, he won 4 Stanley Cups. Today, his legacy lives on at Tim Hortons. What a great place to be.
Tim Hortons, let's go. Beginning of the lake.
Yeah. There you go.
Here we go. Gas it. These cars are coming fast. Yeah.
Yeah, people like speed over here. Either go too slow or too fast. There's nothing in between.
Well, they're coming up behind me right now. I better.
Oh, that's a big pickup truck. Kick
it on.
Past it. Oh my God.
Whoop. Oh, leave that down. It's hot in here. So beautiful here. We're about halfway on our journey up to Terrace, BC. We just passed Williams Lake, British Columbia. Dry, dusty town. The Williams Lake Stampede, that's their claim to fame. But we gotta move on. So for the next few hours, we'll be heading north. Do you hear the ice crackling? Mm-hmm. I do. Let's, can we get closer?
Yeah, and that's Douglas here.
On our way down to the lake here, I'll let you guys know about the numerous rest spots dotted all the way up so far. I mean, it seems like every 10 miles is a rest spot. So if you need to pull over for the night, you can do that.
Mm-hmm.
And they almost all have bathrooms too. Okay.
Listen to the...
Now we're gonna listen to the ice.
Isn't it cool?
That's soothing.
Uh-huh. Oh.
You know what? I think I saw this pack of swans down in Bellingham last week. They're all the way up here now.
They're going to north instead of south.
Oh, that's how that goes. Oh, whoops.
Where are the, right? Frozen. But now it's melting. But look at the ice. It formed exactly. Look at this.
Can you see that? That's like an ice fossil. Onward! To Smithers, BC. And I'll let you know, this McLeese Lake rest area, magnifique.
Oh, that was nice.
Another great thing about these Canadian highways is this passing lane. Let's go! This guy was only going 70 miles an hour and I want to go 85 because we need to get up to Terrace today.
Today,
so.
Why is it a surprise to me today?
A surprise to you?
A little bit.
Because it's your birthday?
It is my birthday for real.
It is.
Yeah.
Let's kick it into full gear and get up to 85 miles an hour.
Okay.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Again, the passing lane stopped and I didn't even make it.
What? Shit. It's actually a very beautiful part. Kind of reminds me of Volga. It looks like part of Russia where the city of Nyanovsk is. Rolling hills, lots of forest and river and lots of agriculture. So kind of feels like I'm not back home, but the place I visited.
And let's look at this map here. 163 kilometers of Prince George. We're making it, people. We're making it.
Oh, wow. Okay, well.
We are 5 hours away from Smithers and 7 away from Terrace, so we're making pretty good headway.
Yeah.
Denny's. Not quite halfway through the day. They got Denny's up here?
Yeah. And Walmart, of course, Walmart.
An American favorite, Denny's and Walmart. Got wood. Got wood. I think there's wood over there. We're gonna make quick work of Prince George. On north.
No, we're supposed to go to pass through Fraser or something to Fort Fraser, and it's like now it's much further.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But eventually we're going to make it to Smithers.
Yeah.
Hopefully before dark. We're safe. We're finally seeing some mountains over here. So I think we're gonna end up slowing down. We were going real fast for a while there. Oh man, that looks kind of fresh. Alrighty, we're gonna take it nice and easy, eh?
Yeah, getting white knuckles so red, you see my fingers?
Yeah.
Dusty.
Yeah, we're kind of doing a dry powder wash. Oh, you can see the ski area up there.
That is cool.
But we're moving beyond the ski area because sounds like it got blown out yesterday and there's not much snow up there anyway. So we're gonna head north again. We'll see.
I know.
We shall see.
Santa Claus decided that North Pole should be Hawaii Pole now or something. I don't know.
I know. North Pole turning Hawaii. Seems like what's happening this winter. Now, where was that Tim Hortons?
Wait.
Just down the road, right? I got to go to Tim Hortons again. It looks like we might be in four-wheel drive for the remainder of our stay here.
Yeah.
This is the way we like it. Nobody in front of us and nobody in back. So we can just easily cruise along on this.
Maybe it means something.
What does it mean? That nobody's going this way?
Yeah.
But that's good. That's usually a good thing. Not a bad thing. Which way do we go? This way?
This way up, and then we need to look for Kitsikula Lake.
There's a tractor crossing here too.
Uh-huh. Really?
We're hitting some fresh powder on this road.
Like, I thought you said tractor.
Tractor crossing.
I'm like, cool. Okay, they can make it.
Country.
Kitsigukula Lake Road. So that's, so.
So we'll be taking a left onto that, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Check out these horses.
Oh.
And there's only a few tracks on this road. There's like nobody going up to this backcountry ski area.
Oh, sweet.
There we go.
there's like two tracks here.
I think we're almost here. And that took us off the highway. That was 25 minutes so far, and we have not seen, it looks like there's one vehicle up here.
Oh God, and we're here. There's one vehicle here. This is fantastic. And they're already taken off, so we're gonna have the place to ourselves. Oh, looks like these guys camped here.
Yes.
We've arrived. Actually, I think I already told you that we arrived because that was the last clip I just did. I want to see if this shows up very well. Here's the map to the ski area that I downloaded. All these cut trails here, and then there's the alpine in the brown there. Currently, the visibility is poor, so we're going to stick to these trees, which should work out well anyway. Pretty shallow snowpack. But we're here.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, up tracks in brown. Uh-huh. Ski runs in white.
White.
And that's the warming shelter up here. This is kind of a cool little...
I like this one.
...set to make, help you understand the topography. So, since it's so cloudy out, we're probably only going to make it up to the warming hut today.
Yeah. That's pretty cool.
And there's the access gate that way.
In at the creamery. I might like that spot.
At the creamery?
Well, ooh. Yeah, you will get fresh
There's a little milk. Advertisement.
Fresh milk, sour
Seabird's tea. Gold. These guys, Canyon Contracting Company. Those guys are great. Uh-huh. And in the Fireweed Motel, you know what? I was looking at that one online.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And a variety of other local businesses.
Oh, maybe these are the sponsors.
Oh, yeah. They might be the sponsors.
Yeah,
oh,
they might be the sponsors.
And this is actually, it's the Bulkley Backcountry Ski Society.
Oh, so they, all of it goes to plowing and maintaining the access road.
There we go.
Provide firewood, maintain cabins, runs and trails, maintain the weather station and website. Ow. Yeah.
Okay, hi diddly ho. Here we go. Trying to ski some of this snow. There's not much of it though. Maybe that's because why nobody's here.
Well, good. I think we'll find some sense. Good stuff.
Yeah. At any rate, it's good to check out something new. Yeah. I've never been to one of these backcountry ski areas.
This must be the bathroom.
Oh yeah, there's the bathroom as well.
Okay.
So they got it all set up here. Yeah, small tracks there, huh? So down at the bottom, it's about a foot base. Which is all right. I mean, it's 1,000 foot vert to the hut. So hopefully we'll be able to ski. Oh wait, no, more than that. It's like 1,200-1,300 to the hut, but we'll probably ski about 1,000 of it. Yeah, what kind of pine is it?
I would like to know because I've never been in this region, but I love pines.
They've got a variety of evergreens here.
Yeah. Like having a cabin here, like you live here.
Oh, a cabin right here would be fantastisch, as the Germans say. Okay, so that way.
For us, which way?
Run 1, 2, 3. And then the day shelter's up at the top of this climb as well. Okay, let's go. Hey, Yulia, how's it going up there?
Easy, but did you just eat snow?
Oh, yeah, I was just checking the moisture content of the snow. Yeah, when I was doing the moisture content test, it couldn't get much moisture out of it.
You still have a little bit on your face. Oh,
well. Mm. All right.
So how's the moisture content?
It's fairly dry.
gain some altitude and that crust is gone underneath.
It's vast out here.
Oh yeah.
Jumps.
Yeah, and you can just kind of get that'll keep your balance in the right position too.
So that was right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I just watched you do it too. Me going down here.
Yeah, we're gonna continue on down and then we'll cut out to the right a little bit lower. Yeah, she could use some more snow, but pretty fun as it is.
Well, what's good about it, we did recon, we learned it, we know where to stay, and we can come back here.
Whenever. Yeah, come back with a full snowpack. So, I'm glad we came.
Yeah, me too.